I packed as much information into the song as I could. But the one thing I had to leave out, I couldn't find a space for it. It was my favorite thing. In 1930, there was a worldwide contest to name the new little planet. And a girl from England, Venetia Burney, 11 years old, she was the winner. She submitted the word Pluto, and one of the reasons why it won is because the first two letters of Pluto are P-L, as in Percival Lowell. Nice. You remember that if you ever go on Jeopardy. Can I hear by your applause, do we have any Jeopardy champions in the house? Disappointed lunch lady. That telling of the song's most up-to-date version, I continually change it when things happen, and I take a poll every time I perform it. I send the results to NASA. So I would love to know, you're here in Colorado, the home of Larry Esposito. Ooh, did you hear that? Somebody's letting the air out of their date. No. Based on what you just heard, how many here tonight believe Pluto is a planet? Okay. How many believe Pluto is not a planet? Despite everything, how many of you believe George W. Bush is goofy? Did I say that out loud? I wasn't supposed to. I've been collecting articles about Pluto's problems, its identity crisis problems. And this is one right here. This is from the New York Times. Planet or no, it's on to Pluto. And it's autographed by the author of the article. He says, "You might just be the smartest person at this concert." This is from the Washington Post. This is about that other new little thing that's even creating more problems for Pluto. And they quoted the lyrics from my song in the Washington Post. I know. No. I didn't know that. How did that happen? And this is another space song I wrote called "If We Had No Moon, What the World Would Be Like If There Was No Moon." Anybody here want to guess what the highest form of life would be if there was no moon? Squid. Think about that next time you order calamari. That's all I'm saying. But